And welcome. I'll try that again. Good evening. Welcome. Thank you for coming, music lovers. Viva la musica. And I'm so glad you're here for our concert tonight, Uniendo Corazones, Uniting Hearts. And our special guests tonight are Prudencio y Jesusa from Mexico City. A little more about them later. But right now, I'm joined on stage by our Santa Rosa Junior College Chamber Singers. My name is Jody Beneke, and I'm the director of the Vocal and Choir program here. And these are the Chamber Singers. They are a select chorus who are given a bit of a rigorous audition, right? Rigorous. Yes, they are. Yeah. And hand-selected. We just came back from performing at University of Southern California for a panel of judges so that we could hear other choirs and compare ourselves to them and do our best work in front of the judges, and we had a really great time. So, Chamber Singers, nice job there. Okay. So tonight we have a mostly Mexican and all Spanish language program. If you know any of the songs, please do sing along. If you don't know the words, just sing anyway. But you'll see, a lot of them will at least keep you tapping your toes, clapping aloud, vocalism is aloud, you know, anything like that. I know, yeah, I want to hear that. We're here to have a very wonderful time. My partners in crime at the piano is Nancy Hashibara. And Steve Hoffman is our bassist, and he will be joining us on select pieces. Prudencio y Jesusa, very many of the pieces that we're performing tonight were specially arranged for us by them, and a couple of pieces were composed originally by them that they will perform for you. So then we stuck in some other pieces that we liked and wanted to present as well. So I think you'll see it's very covers a lot of the Spanish-speaking world, and it'll, I think, delight you, and you may want to get up and dance. We have some dancers here tonight, and it's kind of fun because I haven't seen them. You're seeing them, and I'm seeing them at the same time for the first time. And I know they know what they're doing, so they're just going to show us how to get up and move our buns, okay? So I hope you will be inspired by them. More about that later. Anyway, without too much more talking, we will have a 15-minute interview after this first set is concluded. And there are donation boxes I will remind you about in the lobby, but also you'll get to see some more of those dancers that are here tonight. So I hope you will enjoy that and get a chance to move around before the second half is starting. Anyway, we'll start off with our first number, and I hope you have programs. We are leaving the house lights up so that you can see what's printed in the programs. I hope you picked one up, because if you're not a fluent Spanish speaker, then you will just get an idea, a snapshot of what the song lyrics are about for each song. So that's a really great thing. If not, ask Enrique Rojas is our house manager. Ask him at the intermission to hook you up with a program. He'll be glad to do that. All right, enough about me. Here we go. Our soloists, Grace Gerloff and Lisa Julieta.
the sound of a beating heart, the sound of a heart that is beating for love. Tippy tippy ding, tippy tippy ding. So here we go. Our guest tonight, Prudencio, is actually originally from Bolivia. This is a carnival song from Bolivia. It's just a song everybody sings for fun. We're doing it in a little bit of a special arrangement that makes it tricky and fun. And so it's from an area that is between the border of Argentina and Bolivia. Quebradeño, the border there, and Quebrada, Umahuaqueña, is this ravine that's famous for being a geographical landmark, a deep valley. And then we sing about the things that we're playing. We're making the sounds that sound like these instruments, like a wind instrument or like a charango, which is actually an armadillo that's been made into a guitar kind of thing, and a bombo, that's a big drum, bombo. So tonight you'll hear Carnavalito. We're making all those sound effects.
Jump, 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 jump Pinto para bailar.
La bruja is a very scary lady, the witch. And when you just think you're having a good time flying through the night sky, minding your own business, suddenly you find yourself in her arms. And she will take you and change you into a number of things, flower pots, pumpkins, whatever she's thinking of. And maybe you're asking her, how many children have you eaten? And she'll say, none, none. But you, you I will feed on, you. And that's, your number's up. La bruja. Our soloists for La Paloma are Kevin Ruiz and Jordan Elock. And I didn't translate the whole thing because I know you know a lot. It's a very famous song, very beautiful song. And I just, oh my darling, be mine. Won't you say yes? Won't you say, oh no, yes, no? Okay, keep me guessing. So that's La Paloma a little bit in a nutshell, but it's more beautiful than that. It's so romantic. And I know you will enjoy it.
Thank you.
At this moment, I would like to introduce our guest artists. They have been instrumental in making this whole evening what you are experiencing now. We talked about it when they were here visiting, and they heard a couple of things, I think a couple of performances, maybe Messiah over at the symphony, but also one of our recitals here. And that's because they have a granddaughter who was one of the soloists earlier, Lisa Julieta. And she is their granddaughter, and she's in our voice program. But they, turns out, they're kind of special people. And I got to find out more about them. And I said, oh, what a great thing that would be if we could collaborate. And they said, yes, when? You know, and so we came up with this date, March 13th, and it works for them because they can get away from their school down in Mexico City. And I'm very happy to have them here. This says quite a lot about them, both in Spanish and English. You would be amazed. I find out more things about them both all the time. I was researching a little bit about one of the pieces they're going to sing for you now, and I found out it's inspired by a novel written by Prudencio Bilbao himself. So you can buy that on Amazon. I'm giving you a plug, Prudencio. I'm giving you a little bit. If you would like to, Valeria, and yes, so be sure you look that one up. I was quite impressed, and one of the songs that we are about to hear is inspired by that novel. So they came, and we talked through Lisa for about 3-4 weeks, and then all of a sudden this music started to pour in. You know, and we would sing it and say, how is it? And I said, well, this, that, and the other. Oh, let's change the key. Oh, let's put the tenors over here. Let's do something. And so it was a really great experience for the students to have things coming at them so quickly and then changing. Well, just when they got comfortable, something, you know, would be made better, or through collaboration, some decisions will be made that would improve on the product and the final outcome. And wow, it was a living, breathing thing right in our hands. It was incredible. So when they arrived back, I think it was on the 3rd or 4th of March, and they began immediately, threw themselves in quite selflessly, coming almost every day, sometimes twice a day, here to the school to work with the students directly on the music, on the different coaching them, on the different solos. And they have just been a fantastic experience for us. I'm getting all weepy, but anyway, never mind that. It's when you say uniting hearts, they really... they do that. Prudencio, Jesús.
Thank you. My speaking English is so-so, okay? But this is my rebozo mexicano, my grandmother. This, and this is the nut.
Not.
This is not Alasana. Okay. Is se pone aquí. Vamos a guardar. Ahora recibimos a una Adela. Último nudo. ¿No?
Imperial.
Classroom, what's the deal?
Yeah, I think that was wonderful. Thank you. Yeah, we have dancers. Did you know? So excited. And they are called?
Es el grupo Quetzalén.
Quetzalén. So, gracias. And they are going to, first of all, that was wonderful. And thank you so much. Their dancers are going to maybe lead the way out into the lobby now because we have a short intermission so that you can get some air and go to the restroom before the second half when we get the Santa Rosa Symphonic Chorus up here. And it won't be a long second half either. It'll be about like this and maybe a little bit, tiny bit longer, but not much. And so you'll have a chance to go in the lobby, and I believe you are going to present a dance out there for us. And so I invite you to go ahead and enjoy that. 15 minutes is the time, and then I will expect you all back here. Let's synchronize our watch. Oh, I said it would be 8:15. It's 8:13. I'm pretty good. So please be back here no later than 8:30. Please, we are back in our seats, and we will continue. Thank you very much. You will see donation boxes, and I know you have loose change, and if you have the big bill, that's fine. We can't change it, so just put it in. Just put those big bills right in there. It's fine. We'll take them and hold them up to the light, you know, make sure they're okay. And I just want you to know, because we have those donation boxes, we are able to have guest artists like Prudencio y Jesusan. We are able to have dancers, and we are able to buy things that help us to feel more festive and like we are in fiesta mode, and we can entertain the audience. There is a reception immediately following this performance in the second half. That's a good reason to stay. We have food. Yeah, you don't want to miss that. So we have a little reception out there on the side, and you know, at the end of the performance, we'll all meet in the lobby, photo ops. I got to take a picture with you, Lisa. I just have to. Yeah, that's great. And you with me. Look, I never look like this either. Yeah. And I'm going to do it more often now. Yeah, I think it's a look for me. It works. And so I just want you to please have a lovely evening and meet us at the end and do say a few words to Prudencio y Jesusa. Music is everybody's language. So if you can speak to them in Spanish, great. If you can speak in English, they're pretty good at that too. But we all feel a lot better in our own tongue, you know. But singing, everybody can speak together in singing, so in music. So do stay afterwards and thank you. And I will see you back here 8:30 sharp. Thank you.
I heard such great cheering. It must have been really fun out there. I'm glad you had a good time. Thank you so much. I'm sure you were donating like mad after all that great pleasure that you were getting, and all that donut, those change boxes are full, right? There's still the reception. Oh, okay. Yeah. All right, so welcome back for part two. This is the Santa Rosa Symphonic Chorus standing here behind me. And you will recognize they folded in some of the members of the Santa Rosa Junior College Chamber Singers, and so we are all one unit. And here they are on stage. They have also an entire program of all Spanish, mostly Mexican pieces for you to offer right now. And I'm looking forward to that. I know we all are, right? Yes. And we're kind of excited to see where the dancers will come out. It's like, we don't know. So, but it's fun, and I know it's been planned very carefully by the director. And so we're going to have a wonderful time. And I hope you are looking at your programs for clues about the music. Just, you know, get you in the right track so you're not wondering why we're all so sad. And then happy, you know, and so you can see that. I'm joined again by partners in crime, Nancy Hashibara. Prudencio Bilbao will also be playing a lot of music for us tonight. Theo Shatnoff is running our sound for us tonight. Theo, we couldn't do it without you. Yeah, so we appreciate having you. Thank you, all those people at Media Services. I love them. Anyway, thank you. Okay, so are you ready?
Yes!
Excellent. So our first number is a really nice dance number. Most of these pieces are really nice dance numbers, if you'll notice. So if I'm swaying like that, maybe you can sympathetically do the same, you know, and enjoy yourself. That's the big thing. Veracruz is a wonderful piece, very descriptive of the place that is known, Veracruz, very much loved, beautiful beach area, and we help you to hear the sound of the surf. You will hear it. It'll be like it's right here with you. We're helping you.
Sí, con la materia.
we're available for weddings and celebrations. We have a great dance list. Call me. La Adelita, I looked up a little bit about this song, and it's very hard to find out what is true and what is not about it. It definitely celebrates the female as an equal member in the troops of the Mexican Revolution in this case. And whether or not it's a true story, some people say it is, some people say it isn't. Some people say this woman wrote the song, and some people say she did not. But it is a great song, and if it is true, it's a fun song about Adelita, who's fighting next to the... She's very much admired by all the men in the troops, but the sergeant really loves her. He really, really loves her. But unfortunately, he falls mortally wounded, but before he dies, he sings her this wonderful song that he will follow her, even if she were to leave with someone else, everywhere she goes, either on a battleship or on a troop train, he will be there. La Adelita.
Thank you.
This is a special arrangement from the Sociedad Boliviana and Niña Camba, and it's a very, very compelling, overwhelming, romantic, sort of tortured romantic song about this man's love for this very special light-skinned girl, Niña Camba.
No, no, no.
many of you know Cielito Lindo? Good. Do you know all the verses? Oh, we do. So we'll sing that for you. Yeah. This is an a cappella version by Dick Sharon, who wrote for the movie
Pitch Perfect.
Thank you. Anyway, so it's definitely a different kind of approach to Cielito Lindo, but I think you'll see it fits right into a celebration kind of thing, like you're at a carnival or something, and this would be playing. This is Kukuru Kuku, and I love this song with all my heart, and a lot of times I've heard very many wonderful soloists sing it because it's beloved over the whole world. And tonight our special soloist is Kevin Ruiz.
Oh, triste, muy de mañana le fue a cantar a su casita sola con sus puertitas de par en par. Juran que esa paloma no es otra cosa más que su alma, que todavía le espera a que regrese la desdichada.
I love the light of dawn because it kisses you and makes you alive, alive and fanciful. I just love this poem, I have to read it. Straight tassel to the wind of noon, I love the sun that gilds you, ripe and mine. Alas, heart of the night, finery of the day, my life, I am longing for your happiness. And I'll stop there and let you hear the rest while we sing it.
Hallelujah.
Amor a luz del alma, porque te besa, porque te besa.
to one of our favorite moments, Aresta Mayab, which I did my best to translate, but it's kind of all over the place because it sounds like somebody's getting dressed for a party. And I think it's kind of what that is. And the rebozo is part of that, and the zapatos that have the special heels that you can dance. And so I did my best to find a way that, to say that with rebozo of Santa Maria, mestizas that dance full of joy. Let's go to the party. We are going to earn a place, yeah? We will tap, so we will take out your pretty suit and your colored ribbons, pretty girl, and that's those silk embroidered shoes. Your step will be amusing and more beautiful. So I just want to get up and dance to this, and I think you will want that too. Jesusa will be our soloist together with Aiden Cummings.
Thank you. Well,
I'm really grateful and to say that it's an honor for me to share the stage with such a human being like Jody Benek. She is a very sensitive woman, a great musician. She's a great singer. And we both were chosen by her to come to sing and share his music, our music, his students, his singers, and his musician with us. All this concert is about love. You know, but love is a terrible thing, maybe. Our great writer Octavio Paz in Mexico found through through his investigations that the feeling of love was not recognized in half a century, I mean in that century 12. That was the first information that he had, that love was finally recognized as a feeling human. Before that, no. There was no love. Well, now, you have many ways to express love. But English say it in a very special way. It's in Spanish, you say enamora. In English, you fall in love. Yes. And yes, and falling, it's very dangerous. Okay. So, why is it important? Why it is important to consider love? This is a union of hearts between Mexico and Santa Rosa in particular, yes, through love. It's because it's important. You can say unifying hearts, yes, but in those, in that meaning, you hug in Mexico that way. You don't hug to the front.
What's that?
No, you hug to the left, so both hearts get joined. That's the way Mexican hug. And this was, and it is, a great experience about love. I know there are some friends of many years ago, and I'm very ashamed about my English, because he lives now, I think Marcelo Paz is here. And where? Oh, great, Marcelo. And he has absolutely beautiful English. And when I talk to him, no, he's here about 50 years ago. So it would be a shame if he doesn't have a good English. Great. So please, I would like to make a special recognition to these beautiful voices. All of them, they understood our music. And when I came to the first rehearsal, the first day, I think they were singing my first arrangement, Madrigal, the first piece you heard, and I just started to cry. I couldn't stand up. It was crying deeply, because their voices just touch my heart, and that is the meaning of love.
Love. Yes.
Finally, a great piano player, Nancy. and our wonderful bass player, Steven. Musicians always have to work and run for period in another place, so I'm sure he made it. Yes. Okay. So Jody, it was a very nice experience to be with you, and special thanks to Santa Rosa Junior College for keeping us here these days. Oh, it's great, and a special thanks to my son and his wife that made a great effort to have us here. We love them. We love our family.
Yeah!
Oh my God!
¿Quieren otra canción o quieren la misma canción final? ¿Cuál quieren ustedes?
El final.
El final. La final, porque no. Y quiero agradecer a nuestro técnico, que sin él esto no sale.
Maya,
Aires and Maya. Leo, that one. Go for it, baby. Just can't. Okay. ¿Todavía están los bailarines? Ya se fue. ¡Qué barbaridad! Pues yo le bailo. ¿Qué muchacho tan guapo me pusieron aquí? Muchacho. El maestro Prudencio es muchachón.
¡México!
flyer for this concert tonight, and many of us signed it. And
I wrote, I will cry. Con corazones agradecidos, con todo amor, con amistad de ahora en adelante, la música es el lenguaje de todos, Jody. So anyway,
that will be on their wall. I hope it was okay in Spanish. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
I don't have a speech prepared, except to say that, oh my gosh, it's 9:26, and I said it'd be over at 9:30. I'm just a genius. Look at me. So I would like it if my wonderful Dean of Arts and Humanities, Carrie Lowen, is out in the lobby, and he has and Enrique Rojas, our wonderful front of house manager. There is food there. There are water bottles there. So please eat and drink everything, and be sure we don't have any leftovers. I hope you enjoy it. Some of us up here are going to have to run to beat you to it, but no, we won't. You eat it. And thank you very much for being here. Please spend some time. We're going to try to get Jesus and Prudencio out in the lobby as soon as possible. So you can just say hello and you know, be nice. Take a selfie. Okay, thank you so much for being here. Thank you.